So you have a Superman script for me?
Yes, sir, I do.
That sounds like fun.
No.
No?
Yeah, no, it's gonna be real serious and real gritty.
Oh, it is.
Right, because remember how the Dark Knight trilogy made a bunch of money?
Are you kidding me? That's all I think about ever.
Yeah, so I figure we could do that dark, gritty origin thing again, but this time with Superman.
Do you think it matters that Superman is much more of a hopeful and colorful hero than the Dark Knight?
I don't think anything matters.
Interesting worldview. All right, so what happens in the movie?
Well, the planet Krypton is about to explode, so Superman's dad, Jor-El, is planning on sending him off to Earth.
Aren't any other Kryptonians gonna leave the planet too?
No, Jor-El tells this council that everyone on this planet is already dead.
If they're gonna put a baby Superman on a spaceship, why can't they put other people on spaceships too?
Because.
Fair enough.
Anyway, then this bad guy, Zod, is gonna try to take over and they're gonna stop him.
Oh, so what do they do with him?
Well, they banish him from the planet.
So they can launch a baby into space and they can launch bad guys into space, but they have to stay on a planet that's gonna explode?
That's what we're going with.
Well, okay then.
Anyway, so Superman's gonna be raised as Clark Kent in Kansas, and his adoptive father wants him to keep his identity a secret.
Okay.
So when Clark is a kid and he saves a bunch of kids from drowning, his dad's like, maybe you shouldn't have done that.
What?
Yeah, he's like, you know, your secret is that important. You probably should have just stood around and watched all your classmates drown.
Wow, he must really care about that secret.
Yeah, so anyway, then he tells Clark about the time that he brought a bit of his spaceship stuff to a specialist who told him it wasn't from this Earth.
Wait, so Clark has to keep it a secret, but he can bring some space junk to a guy?
That's right.
Wow, super unfair.
And then we're gonna have this thing where Pa Kent dies in a tornado because he doesn't want Clark to help him.
Why?
Because if a person saves someone from a tornado, that person is automatically an alien.
Feels like there might be other conclusions people would come to before that one.
Well, Pa Kent doesn't want to risk it, so he lets himself die.
Huh.
Anyway, so when Clark is older, he's confronted by this jerk at a truck stop bar, and he restrains himself from kicking the guy's butt.
Oh, that's great. It's important to show that he's the bigger man, and plus this way he won't draw attention to himself.
Yeah, but then he's gonna impale the guy's truck on some massive logs.
What?
Yeah, then he leaves.
That's much more suspicious and also makes him seem like a petty character.
Yeah, but it's gonna look cool visually.
Oh, it is. Okay, never mind the story and character and theme.
Great.
So what else happens in the movie? Is Lois Lane in it?
You bet, and she also has superpowers.
What do you mean?
Well, she can survive in minus 40 weather with no problem at all. She can teleport across the city to show up where she needs to be. And she's somehow able to resist the pull of a massive gravity machine.
Those are some pretty impressive powers.
Yeah, so anyway, later in the movie, Superman and Zod are gonna have this massive fight in Metropolis.
So Clark is gonna lure Zod away from the city?
No, he's gonna punch him through some buildings.
Okay, but then he's gonna lure him away from the city?
No, he's gonna punch him through some buildings for 40 minutes.
Oh my god.
Yeah. So many people are gonna die you don't even know.
Feels like it's gonna be difficult to keep a fight scene interesting for 40 minutes.
Actually, super easy. Barely an inconvenience.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we're gonna keep things spicy by throwing in some, you know, extremely generic dialogue.
How generic are we talking?
Well, Zod's gonna be like, there's only one way this thing ends, Cal. Either I die or you do.
Wow.
And also Clark is gonna be like, you're a monster, Zod, and I'm gonna stop you.
That is so incredibly generic, I love it.
Also, Superman and Lois Lane are gonna kiss.
Why?
Well, he saved her from falling, and also they're like an iconic couple, right?
Right, but did we build up a romance between them in the movie?
Not really.
And aren't they standing in the middle of a bunch of dead bodies and destroyed buildings?
Yeah, it's gonna be super romantic.
You have a pretty weird concept of romance.
Yeah, I had a weird childhood.
Weird childhoods are tight.
Oh yeah, brother.
So how does the movie end?
Well, Zod is about to use his heat vision to kill a family, so Superman has to stop him before he does.
So he grabs him and flies away with him?
No.
He uses super speed to get the family out of the way?
No, sir, he doesn't.
He steps in front of the blast and takes the hit himself?
No, he breaks Zod's neck.
What?
Yeah, and then he screams because he's so upset that he had to do that.
Feels like there were a lot of other options, though.
Whoops.
Whoopsie.
Anyway, so yeah, then the city's destroyed and thousands of people are dead and Superman killed someone.
Wow, how are we gonna deal with the aftermath of that?
We're not. We're gonna jump forward in time.
Oh, we're not gonna deal with the consequences?
No, that would be super difficult. Very much an inconvenience.
Fair enough.
Yeah, maybe in a future movie or something. I don't know.
Well, okay then.
So yeah, we're gonna jump forward in time and have Superman destroy a $12 million military drone and be like, stop following me, you jerk.
Wow.
And then he's gonna get hired at the Daily Planet despite having no experience.
And people aren't gonna realize that he's Superman?
No, because he has glasses.
Oh, I figured since we were going the gritty route, we would do away with that whole glasses hide his identity thing.
No, that stays.
If you say so.
So what do you think?
Well, honestly, man, as long as this lays the groundwork for the DCEU, I'm happy, you know?
I hear ya. Justice League movie, here we come.
Oh yeah, that's when we're really gonna cash in on these superheroes. Hey guys, Ryan here. Hope you like that pitch meeting. Let me know in the comments section what other movies you'd like to see pitches for. We also have a lot of these on the channel that you can check out, like over 50 now, I think. And if you did like this one, you could give it a like, maybe subscribe to the channel, share it on Facebook and Twitter, and check back soon for a new one. Bye-bye.